Minimum wage hikes in Mimaropa and Sokcerjen have also been approved by regional wage boards. In Mimaropa, workers in private establishments will get 35 pesos more in their daily wages, raising the minimum wage rate to 329 pesos and 355 pesos for those working in companies with 10 or more employees. Meanwhile, private workers based in Sokcerjen will receive their wage increase of 32 pesos in two tranches. This brings the new minimum wage rate in the region to 368 pesos for the non-agriculture sector and 347 pesos for the agri-service and retail establishments. The Visayas chapter of the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry wants the minimum wage hike for Western Visayas workers deferred. Workers in the region are supposed to get a 55 to 110 peso wage increase beginning June 5. But BCCI Visayas asserts the timing of the wage hike is off and they were not consulted about the matter.
First of all, this is highly abnormal nga times. Indeed, is ang ila pag-process is as it normal time. For 2 days, they deliberated, after that, tapos na, they send it.
But the Western Visayas Regional Wage Board insists the wage hike should be implemented since the last salary increase in the region was imposed back in 2019.
Yung appeal nila to the commission, hindi makapigil na pag-implement ng wage order unless they are going to post a superstitious fund or surety to satisfy the commission.
Will it amount to millions, no? Because it will cover the amount to be paid to the workers, no?
A labor group is pushing for a 100 billion peso subsidy loan for micro, small, and medium enterprises to speed up the country's economic recovery. Federation of Free Workers President Sunny Matula says the recent wage hikes are not enough to boost the economy. He believes strengthening MSMEs, which in turn would create more jobs, would bring more inclusive growth in the country. The group is also pushing for national minimum wage to avoid discrimination. Heads up for motorists, here are the pump price adjustments for this week. Gasoline prices expected to go up to 4 pesos and 50 centavos per liter, but diesel and kerosene prices may be slashed by around 2 pesos and 50 centavos per region. Industry players say the start of the driving season in the U.S. factored in the price increases. China starting to ease lockdown restrictions also a reason for the price movement. The Philippine Tax Bureau suspends the creation of special audit task forces following an order from the Finance Department. This after a row between Megaworld and the BAR, which sent an advisory on serving a closure order only to suspend it immediately. The Finance Department said the order is meant to avoid confusion among taxpayers and prevent duplicated investigations. The task forces are barred from operating until further notice. The BAR immediately followed the directive and also suspended special audits on online cockfighting and Philippine offshore gaming operators, or POGOs.